The Philippine Science and Technology Department has scrapped its clinical trial on the use of anti-parasitic drug ivermectin for COVID. DOSD Secretary Fortunato de la Peña says the study found it difficult to get ethics clearance. He adds the Department of Health has decided to use the nearly 48 million peso fund on other matters. Medical experts earlier warned against the use of ivermectin, saying a number of Filipinos were still infected with COVID despite using the drug.
Wala pa rin naman kasing dumadating na bagong development sa international trial on the benefits of ivermectin.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos nagkaroon pa ng issuance sa atin dito locally against the use of ivermectin. Pero ang pinaka-immediate cause natin, unang-una ay nagdaan tayo sa talagang paunti ng paunti ang pasyente na maaaring mag-participate sa trials. Pangalawa, nahirapan kaming kumuha ng supplier ng gamot kasi pag nalaman nilang gagamitin sa trial ay umaatras sila. Siguro ay natatakot siguro silang.
The Philippines logged 191 new COVID cases Sunday, a day after fresh infections hit their highest number since May 1st at 246. Professor Jomar Abahante of the University of the Philippines' COVID-19 pandemic response team says the country will continue to see a slight increase in cases due to waning vaccine immunity. He urges local government units to continue their monitoring and surveillance efforts to prevent bigger outbreaks.
Most of the Filipino people got their first two shots prior to December 2021. It's already May. We're going to June. It's around 6 months already. And only few people, around 3.9 million, got their first booster shot. So, and mostly they got this first booster shot around January, February 2022. So for the next third or fourth quarter of 2022, we might see, you know, people getting sick. However, this increase in cases may not be detected because one of the reason is only the severe and critical, no, symptomatic people are being targeted for detection.
A government advisor believes the rollout of second booster shots should be expanded to more groups. Dr. Ted Herbosa says the Philippines should use vaccines that are about to expire on those who want them. He adds, expanding the eligibility for the fourth dose is important following the detection of Omicron subvariants here in the Philippines.
I think we should open up the second booster for more than 6 months, the way the US CDC has done. In fact, many groups have been calling for that. The group of Mr. Joey Concepcion, the presidential advisor for entrepreneurship, because he's trying to protect the businesses and the industry. We need to protect the workers also that's moving around.
Yeah.
So he's saying, why not give them, the frontline workers as well, their second booster?
For a presidential advisor, COVID alert levels in the country should not be raised despite the threat of Omicron subvariants. Secretary Joey Concepcion believes expanding the COVID booster coverage is key to ensuring the health and safety of the public. He warns reimposing strict COVID protocols will just hurt the economy.
Ang economy natin is doing very well now, no? At kailangan sumiglat to kasi yung kailangan natin dito is job generation. Yung mga wage increases na 33 pesos, okay lang yan. Pero kung magsisirado tayo uli kasi tataas yung mga alert level from alert level 1 to 2 or even 3, then halos yung mga maliit na negosyante na maarangkada na, syempre mawawala ang kumpiyansa, pati yung mga banko na sila nagpapautang uli sa mga MSMEs. Huwag natin itaas yung alert levels natin. No? Kahit tumaas yung infection level, kahit thousands yan, pero yung hospital capacity natin ay talagang mababa pa rin. Dapat tuloy-tuloy pa rin itong alert level 1, no? Katulad sa ibang bansa.